Sziasztok! Echte vagyok, és folytatódik a Broken Sword. Ott hagytam abba a legutóbbi részben, hogy sikerült kinyitni egy óriási kőajtót, a Lokmáni kastély rejtett pincéjében, amit Pigram professzor talált meg minden bizonnyal. És hát akkor lássuk, hogy mi van benne. Irány az ajtó. Ez volt.
So, where did you stay last night?
At McDevitt's. I got to drinking with Doyle and a couple of the guys.
That explains why you look so ill today. Did you get any sleep at all?
Not much. I had to share the room with another guy.
Did he snore?
Hardly. He was dead.
And you say Pigram has disappeared?
Without a trace. But my visit wasn't a complete waste of time.
Pigram's gem?
The Templar's gem. Whoever Jacques Marquet is, he's in for a disappointment.
Jacques Marquet?
He's the guy who should have collected the gem from Fitzgerald.
What are your plans?
I want to find out who, what, or where Montfaucon was. All I've got to go by is the name and a picture of a hanged man.
Így van. Amit láthattunk, ugye ez a Montfaucon felirat, azon a képen, alatta pedig egy akasztott ember.
Let's take another look at the manuscript.
Megnézhetjük újra a kéziratot. Ugye itt ez az ékkő, amit megszereztünk, ez pedig ott van ugye a múzeumban, az állványzata. Jó, végül is ezeket már ugye átbeszéltük. Lehet róla újra tanakodni, de végül is mindegy. Ha legyen egy kicsit pep talk.
You speak very good English for a French girl.
Thanks. You speak very good English for an American.
Tell me more about yourself.
Oh, there is not much to tell.
Well, how did you get into photography?
I guess I owe that to my father. He bought my first camera. I was 8 and my parents had just split up.
Did you live with your father?
Yes, my mother went off with her new boyfriend. I don't mind. Papa was all I needed. 4 years later, he died in a plane crash.
Ah, I'm sorry.
Well, it's all right. I don't mind talking about him. He was more like an older brother, really. Always joking and laughing. Papa always wanted I should study art. That's why I went to college.
Did you learn about photography at college?
Oh, God, no. I couldn't afford the materials. We were billed for everything we used, paint, canvas, paper. Most of my year turned to minimalism, it was cheaper. I used to go poaching in the park for squirrel hair. The only time I wasn't hungry was the term I did printing. I used to eat the potatoes.
You're making fun of me, aren't you?
Oh no!
Do you have a boyfriend?
Not anymore.
A lényeges kérdés.
There was someone. A guy in my final year. But it didn't work out. Neither did my degree.
I'm sorry.
I'm not.
Tell me more about your family.
When I was a little girl, I used to spend the winter with my grandfather and grandma. They were the best times, warm and safe in their tiny cottage. My grandfather rolled cigarettes while my grandma made hot chocolate and cakes. One day, he stopped his rolling. He put the lid back on the tobacco jar and took me in his arms. I laughed and wriggled. But he hushed me to be silent. And with his unshaven chin all scratchy in my ear, he told me a secret.
What did he say?
He said, I don't smoke, but she likes to think I do.
What a weird old man.
Don't call my grandfather weird. He was the nicest guy ever. I wish I was back in that cottage, instead of this crummy apartment in this noisy city.
Csak azért gondoltam, hogy kicsit jobban megismerjük Nikót.
Can't sit here all day, much as I'd like to.
Okay, Don't forget to look for Lobinot at the Kron Museum.
Ja, tényleg.
And why don't you see if Rosso has heard anything?
Okay. Anything else I can do for you while I'm out? Shopping, a trip to the laundromat?
Just take care of yourself.
Kicsit jobban megismertük Nicole-t. Aki mondta, hogy emlékeztetett rá, hogy Lobinóval még mindig nem beszéltünk, ugye a múzeumban, amúgykor nem volt ott, lehet, hogy azóta már ott van. És, hogy Rosszót is megkérdezhetnénk esetleg, hogy hogy halad a nyomozással, ezt a tanácsot fogadjuk meg, úgyhogy gyerünk a rendőrségre. Megnézzük, milyen a párizsi rendőrös, szép, tágas, jó, üres. Ahhoz, hogy Rosszóval beszélsünk, természetesen először Mou-val kell.
Excuse me.
Ah, Monsieur Stobart, n'est-ce pas?
That's correct. You remember me.
The retention of such data is part of my duty as a gendarme. That is how crime is fought, through attention to detail, not intuition.
Yes, sure.
Rosszóval kapcsolatban kérdezzük.
Is Rosso here?
Yes, he is. You wish to speak to him?
Aga.
Yes, I do.
One moment, monsieur. Stobart is here to see you, monsieur.
Did he say what it was about?
No, monsieur.
Very well.
Hi, Inspector, remember me?
But of course, Mr. Stobart. My mind is a well-ordered faculty. A mental classification system that's the envy of the Bibliothèque Nationale. No tricks, mark you, monsieur. Just exercise.
Annak érdekes fordítása.
Just as our muscles waste through inactivity, so our minds decay. But there is no need. If only people would learn to exercise their wits daily.
If he was trying to impress me, it worked. He was pompous and patronizing, but he had style.
Eh bien, if you called about the bombing, you're too late. Investigations have been closed.
But...
I've been taken off the case.
What about the murder, the dead guy?
It is out of my hands.
Kérdezzük Jacques Marquet-val kapcsolatban.
Ever heard of a guy called Marquet? Jacques Marquet?
Marquet? I know the name well. He has a record for suspected blackmail, kidnapping, arson, and art theft.
An all-rounder, huh? How come he's on the loose?
His bravado is matched only by the courtroom skills of his attorney.
Ennyit tud Marquet-ról. Kérdezhetjük Carl is.
Don't you want to know what I found out about the killer?
I told you, monsieur, the case is closed. I have washed my hands of the whole affair.
Then I'll have to continue my investigations without your help.
No. You must forget the business of the clown completely. Go back to being an ordinary tourist, Stobart.
Jó, nem nagyon tudunk meg tőle semmit.
So long, Inspector.
Elbúcsúzhatunk. Szó nélkül vissza is megy. Azért volt inkább erre szükség, hogy most beszéljünk Mou-val.
Excuse me.
What do you want now?
És most kérdezzük őt Marquet-ról.
Have you heard of a man called Marquet?
Yes. He used to be known as the Mole of Montmartre. I heard he's been hospitalized, probably by one of his rivals.
Which hospital was Marquet taken to?
The Hagenmeyer Clinic, in the Avenue des Hérissons.
Na, erre az infóra volt szükségünk. Kórházban van Marquet, meg is tudtuk, hogy melyik.
Why was Marquet known as the Mole of Montmartre?
Because he lived in Montmartre, I suppose.
Yeah, but why the mole?
I don't know. Maybe he ruined people's lawns.
See you later, Sergeant.
Köszönjük az infót Mou-nak. Úgyhogy irány a kórház. Ami Itt is van.
The old building managed to retain some of its original grandeur, but the modern additions look like a baseball cap on a statue of a medieval saint.
Ezek a meglátások, hát kérem szépen, gyerünk be! Beszéljünk a recepciósal, itt az igencsak szintén tágas előtérben.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Is this the Hagenmeier Clinic?
That's correct.
I thought I was in a garden center.
Oh, the plans. They were my idea. A little greenery to evoke the spirit of nature. How may I help you?
Mutassuk meg neki Merlin, azaz Khan kártyáját.
Look at this ID pass.
So you're Merlin. Marquet's been asking for you.
For me?
Yes. He was shouting your name when they brought him in here. Now, let me see. He was on ward B12, as I recall. Oh, he's being transferred to... Oh dear. He's on ward J2. That's... Nurse Grendel's ward.
Kérdezzük Grendel nővérről.
What's so bad about Nurse Grendel?
She runs that ward like a South American prison.
Keeping a well-disciplined ward isn't a crime, is it?
Well-disciplined. In the discipline and punishment stakes, she'd whip the butt off the Marquis de Sade. Everything, I mean everything, is done to a strict routine. 6 o'clock, alarm call. 6:10, bowel movements, and woe betide anyone who doesn't have a result. Those patients of hers are like Pavlova's dogs.
She sounds like a real nightmare.
And then some.
If Nurse Grendel is that bad, how come the authorities tolerate her?
She's like part of the furniture.
Oh, you mean she's been here a long time?
No. I mean there's not a man in this clinic who hasn't sprawled out on her.
I was beginning to get the picture. This woman was jealous, with a big green capital J. How do I find Nurse Grendel's ward?
Down the corridor on the left, turn right at the senior consultant's washroom. Right again at the executive coffee lounge. Bear left past the administrator's sauna. And turn left at the end. That's J2. And good luck.
Okay.
Thanks for your help, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Köszi, köszi. Szóval Márki ott van a J2-es osztályon rendelnővérnél. Mi most akkor induljunk el itt ezen a baloldali folyosón. Ezt a hangot hallottuk.
I saw the source of the hellish noise which echoed through the corridors. It was an industrial polishing machine with an odd-looking guy in tow.
Éppen súrolja itt a padlót. Itt hátul van egy folyosó, itt jöjjünk át. És húzzuk ki a falból a konnektort. Vagy hát a dugót.
As I tugged the plug out of the socket, the polishing machine coughed, spluttered, and died.
Mr. Shiny, what's wrong, pal?
Ragyi. Azt gondolom, a ragyogóból vagy ragyogásból jön. Mr. Ragyi. Na, megtalálta. Közben mi viszont, amíg visszatér, be tudunk ide nézni, és George ki is kap egy orvosi köpenyt, amit hirtelen magára is ránt.
Dr. Stobart at your service.
Megint mit mondtam. Na, mindegy. Jó. Most pedig akkor menjünk vissza. Most hirtelen, nem minden jöttünk. Jó, arra nem volt semmi, akkor innen jöttünk. Így van. Beszéljünk akkor itt az idősebbik orvoshoz. Most már ugye mi is orvosnak adjuk ki magunkat.
Hi, my name's George Stobart.
Aha, just the man. You must be the new boy.
Yeah, I must be.
Well, stop wandering about and make yourself useful. Bernie, come here, boy. This is Benoit, my nephew. Can I trust you to look after him?
Do your own babysitting, Gramps. Who do you think you are, anyhow?
I am Felix Hagenmeier.
And may I say what an honor it is to meet you in person, sir. You are on my medical wall of fame. Right up there with Pasteur and Leary. I look on it as a privilege, no, an honor, to look after your nephew, sir.
Is fresh out of medical school. It will open his eyes to see a real doctor on the job.
I'll bet.
Show him around. Let him see some real suffering.
Ránk bízta az unokaöcsét. Legyen így. Aki követni fog minket, menjünk akkor itt újra a baloldali folyosón. És automatikusan követve az utasításokat meg is érkezett a J2-es osztályra.
Good afternoon, doctor.
Oh, hi. Is this ward J2?
Yes, sir. The patients are ready for your inspection, doctor.
Thank you, nurse. Well, who's first?
Monsieur Croquet in bed 2.
What's his problem?
He's been complaining of loss of consciousness. You'll need this, doctor.
She gave me a long, narrow metal box and a stunning smile. Thanks. Hi, I'm Dr. Stobart.
Hello, doctor.
The nurse told me you keep losing consciousness.
That's right. I've had the problem as long as I can remember. It's a real out-of-body experience. Like death, but not so conclusive.
I see. How long does it last?
Just a fraction of a second, and then I recover.
I might not have been a doctor, but I was formulating a diagnosis all the same. This guy was nuts. I know exactly what you mean. It's known in the medical field as blinking.
Is it serious?
Of course it isn't serious. It's perfectly natural.
But just think. 2 seconds every minute? Why, that's almost half an hour every day. 2 weeks out of every year spent in total darkness.
I don't have time to listen to this baloney.
És így ezt mondja. Jó, nem kell tőle semmit se kérdezni.
Goodbye and good luck.
Thanks, doc.
Beszéljünk újra a nővérrel.
Could you take a look at the client in bed number 3 now? His name is Eric Sopmarsch.
What's his problem?
He's delirious. He just now came out of theater. He's recovering from major surgery.
I'll have him up and about before you can say, Lazarus, get out of your bed and walk. Hello, anybody home?
Who are you?
My name is Dr. Stobart, and I'm here to steer you down the rocky road to recovery.
Dr. Monroe said there was no cure for what I've got.
Your problem is you stayed in bed too long.
Are you sure you're a qualified doctor?
You better believe it.
Tőle se kell kérdezni semmit.
See you later.
Beszéljünk inkább Benoit-hoz.
Hey, Benoit.
There's no need to shout. What do you want?
És adjuk oda neki a vérnyomásmérőt.
Here, take this pressure gauge.
Thank you, sir. What do you want me to do with it?
Well, keep it safe until I think of something.
Így, né? És hogyha el akarunk jönni, hogy elbúcsúzhatunk.
Follow me, Benoit.
I'm right behind you, sir.
El akarunk jönni itt tovább jobbra.
Doctor!
What is it?
You haven't taken my blood pressure.
Kéri a vérnyomásmérést.
I can't take a satisfactory reading while you're excited like this. I'll come back later.
Kérjük meg Benoit, ha már ugye odaadtuk neki a vérnyomásmérőt, hogy mérje meg ő azt a vérnyomást.
Yes, sir?
Are you ready with that pressure gauge?
Primed and ready to pump, sir. What do you want me to do with it?
És kattintsunk Sopmarsra.
Use it on Eric Sopmars.
Okay.
Így, mi pedig így most már szabadon ide jöhetünk, és láthatjuk, hogy egy őr vigyáz egy külön kórtermet, menjünk be.
Rather you than me, pal. Marquet?
Yes. I am Marquet. I've been expecting you.
You have?
Well, what are you waiting for? Get it over with.
I just want to know what I should do with the gem.
The Lochmar gem?
Yeah, right here in my pocket.
Oh, I thought you were one of the Ashashin.
Not me. I never inhaled.
So, you were sent in my place?
Yeah. You could hardly make the trip to Ireland in your condition. What should I do with the gem?
Deliver it to the Grand Master quickly. Tell him that I have found the tripod right here in Paris.
You have it?
Not yet, but it's being taken care of. I hired a couple of stooges with a flair for petty crime.
Would that be Flap and Guido by any chance?
You know them?
We've met. What about the Hashashin?
He's more likely to have followed Klausner. He'll stop at nothing to prevent the reforging of the sword.
And that's bad, is it?
As for Klausner, he's gone off to Syria on a wild goose chase.
They have geese in Syria?
He has a theory about the location of the...
That's enough excitement for one day, Monsieur Marquet. What are you doing here?
Talking to this patient, of course.
Monsieur Marquet is my patient. If Herr Hagenmeier was to hear that...
Okay, I'm going. I'd learned all I could from Marquet anyhow.
Ah, there you are, sir. I was just coming to look for you. I finished with your pressure gauge.
Thanks, Bunny.
What's that noise? It sounds as if someone's having a cardiac arrest.
A tartos.
It's all right. The doctor's in there with him.
Are you sure he was a doctor?
Oui, monsieur. He showed me his ID. It was Dr. Braille.
There's no Dr.
Braille working here?
He's an imposter! The door's locked. Help me, officer.
Stand back, monsieur.
I found Jacques Marquet.
Did he talk?
Yeah, he talked. For the very last time.
He's dead?
Yeah. Killed in cold blood by a bogus doctor.
That's despicable. What kind of guy would pass himself off as a doctor and take advantage of a dying man? Was it Khan?
No. I don't know who he was, but it certainly wasn't Khan. He got away, out the window. Have you ever heard of the Hashi-Ashin?
No.
Marquet said that they were his biggest enemy.
His biggest enemy was the bogus doctor.
Don't remind me. That guy was evil. He had wild, staring eyes like a dead fish. I'll never trust a doctor again.
Hmm.
I guess I'd better go back and talk to that weirdo.
Which one? Rosso or Sergeant Mou? Oh, but you're referring to André.
I'll let you work it out.
Igen, ideje már, hogy a múzeumba is eljussunk. Itt van, Musée Krün.
You have left it very late, monsieur.
Late for what?
Anything. I am closing the museum soon. You wouldn't like to get locked in. I can tell you. Not in this gallery.
Why not?
It is haunted, monsieur.
You don't believe in ghosts, surely.
Oh, yes, I do. 7 years ago, a lad managed to hide in here. He made a bet with his friends, I suppose. When I found him in the morning, he was cold as ice and stiff as a board.
Well, what was the cause of death?
They said it was a brain tumor. But on his face was a look of stark, desperate terror, such as I have never seen before.
Scary.
Forget it.
Forget it. Na itt van Lobino, beszélhetünk vele.
I beg your pardon. Are you André Lobino?
That's me. You want my autograph?
No. I was told you may be able to help me.
Help?
My name is George Stobart. I'd like your professional opinion.
Well, okay, shoot.
Hát kérdezzük mondjuk, mutassuk meg először a kéziratot.
I'd like your opinion on a medieval manuscript.
Vraiment? Do you have it with you?
No, it's too fragile. And besides, there are certain people who'd stop at nothing to get their hands on it.
Intriguing. Do you have a copy of the text?
There isn't much. Only a few Latin phrases. I was kind of hoping you'd help decipher the pictures.
Without seeing the manuscript, that's a tall order.
Just tell me one thing. What does the image of two men riding on the same horse suggest to you?
The Knights Templar. Does the Templar seal appear on this manuscript? I'd love to see that for myself.
Hát mondjuk meg, hogy Nikolnál van.
The manuscript is being looked after by a friend.
In Paris?
Yeah. Not far from here, in fact.
Well, just give me the address and I'll come round and take a look.
I'm not so sure about that. Maybe I should check with her first.
A female friend?
Yeah, she's a woman. Maybe it was my imagination, but I noticed a predatory look in his eye. Suddenly, this friendly historian had turned into the big bad wolf. This friend who has the manuscript?
The anonymous girlfriend.
She lives at 361 Rue Jarry.
She might remember your team.
I know it well. I'll drop by just as soon as I can.
Nem kell félni, nyugodtan meg lehet adni neki a címet. Kérdezzük esetleg a Hashashinról.
Have you ever heard of the Hashashin?
Why yes, it was a radical Muslim sect whose name became synonymous with murder. It was formed in 11th century Persia, shortly before the Crusades.
At roughly the same time as the Templars.
Yes, they gave a new word to our language, Assassini, the Assassins.
How did the Assassins get their name?
From the legends surrounding the secrets of their initiation rites. A young man who sought to join the sect was given hashish until he drifted into dreams. He awoke to find himself in a fabulous garden with everything he could wish for. The freshest water, the most delicious food, the choicest hash, and the most delectable women imaginable.
Cool. Do you have the address?
I haven't finished the story. There was a price to pay for this taste of paradise.
Wouldn't you just know it?
The young man would wake the next day to find himself back in the real world. He was told that he'd been given a glimpse of the heaven reserved for holy martyrs. A heaven he would enjoy for eternity if he was willing to join the Hashashin.
How did the assassins operate?
Well, as I explained, the new recruits would be only too willing to die for the cause. They'd be instructed in the use of the dagger, poisons, and disguise. Then, the Grand Master of the sect would name an enemy of Allah.
And they'd stop at nothing to eliminate that enemy.
You got it. They were fearless and deadly.
Does the cult of the assassin still exist?
Take a look around at the world today. You tell me.
Na, megtudtuk ugye, ha esetleg valami nem tudta volna, hogy az assassin, azaz a bérgyilkos szó, azok a hashashinból valóak, az pedig ugye a hasisból, hát igazából a hasisból jött a bérgyilkos szó az angolban. Kérdezzük meg ugye az akasztott emberről, Montfaçonról mit tud?
Does the name Montfaçon mean anything to you?
Sure, it was the most grisly spectacle in Paris until the revolution.
A public toilet?
Montfaçon was the place of execution for many thousands. A dark temple of death, with row upon row of arches, each one framing a grim exhibit. Scores of rotting corpses swung on creaking rope, while the crows devoured their flesh.
That explains the image of the hanged man. I found a reference to Montfaçon in Ireland, in a village called Lochmarne.
Lochmarne? That's where Pegram was digging.
That's right. He'd left the excavation before I arrived.
Na, Pegramet is ismeri.
Do you know Pegram well?
Not really. I met him at a conference. I would have liked to talk to him in depth, but I didn't have time.
When was this?
Back in the summer, July, I think.
Where was the site of Montfaçon?
To the northeast, near the Canal Saint-Martin, but there's nothing there now. The old gibbet was torn down during the revolution.
Templomosokról is meg lehet kérdezni.
Can you tell me anything about the Knights Templar?
I sure can, Georgie. Soldiers, diplomats, mercenaries, monks, bankers, you name it, the Templars fit the bill. The greatest fighting force in Christendom, the militia of Christ.
Jeez. How did the Templars get their name?
From the building in which they set up their headquarters. The King of Jerusalem gave them part of a mosque on the Temple Mount. It was said to have been the site of the original Temple of Solomon. The order became known first as the Knights of the Temple, and later the Knights Templar.
You're a mine of information, André.
Glad to be of help, Georgie.
How come the Templars became so wealthy?
There was a constant stream of new recruits to their ranks, many from noble families. They were required to swear a sacred oath of poverty, chastity, and obedience. So, their money, goods, and lands were donated to the order. The Templars soon held land in France, Scotland, England, Spain, most of Europe, in fact. the poor Knights of Christ became the wealthiest power in Christendom.
Is it true the treasure of the Knights Templar was never found?
Who knows? So little knowledge of what really happened remains. Oh, if it does, the truth has never been made public.
What do you mean by that?
The Templars have attained mythological status, like the King Arthur of the Britons. There are people even now who say the Templars still exist.
Do you think that's likely?
No, not for a minute.
Na, kis történelmi lecke. Lobinótól még utoljára megkérdezhetjük a tripodról.
I think you ought to know that the tripod is going to be stolen.
The Lochmann tripod? No.
It's true. I can give you a description of the thieves.
Before the supposed event has taken place?
I heard them planning the raid.
They're wasting their time. The tripod is protected by a state-of-the-art alarm system.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you. Why don't you loan the tripod to me for safekeeping?
Because I'd never see it again.
Well, don't you trust me?
It's not a question of trust, George. That tripod is hundreds of years old and extremely fragile.
I get your point.
Ja, ennyit tudtunk meg Lobinótól.
Thanks for your help, André.
You're welcome.
Most pedig, mielőtt itt bezárna ugye a múzeum, amikor az őr másfelé néz, nem mondjuk talán most, nyissuk ki az ablakot.
The rod turned smoothly, and the window above me opened.
Ezzel a karral ő rögtön megy is, hogy becsukja, és amíg így tesz, addig bújjunk be ide ebbe a szarkofágba.
It is closing time, Monsieur Lobinot.
Already, there just aren't enough hours in the day.
More than enough for me. I can't wait to get home and put my feet up.
Eh bien, see you tomorrow.
Good night, Monsieur.
Hoppá, Flap és Guido, ahogy Marké mondta, megjöttek.
Hey Guido, look at this!
Quit fooling around, you moron! Get your ass over here and bring that flashlight!
Tivassuk meg őket, és ezt a totem oszlopot lökjük rájuk.
What the... Who's there?
Let's get out of here!
And when I woke up, I was at the police station. Luckily, I managed to persuade Rosso I was innocent.
Poor George.
What a mess. I bungled the whole thing.
I don't think so. You made a pretty good job of distracting those two crooks.
Yeah, but the killer got away with the tripod.
No, he didn't. He's not the only one who can dress up in costume.
You mean... It was you who stole the tripod? Oh, hell, Nico. I could have been shot.
Those dogs are more likely to shoot their own feet.
I just wish you'd told me your plans. We're supposed to be in this together. But how come you dressed up like a pantomime cat?
Don't silk, Georgie, please.
Oh,
rats. And don't call me Georgie.
Oh, I really thought you'd be pleased. After all, we've got the tripod. Aren't you going to try putting the gem on the tripod?
I guess so.
Azért sok tini fiúnak a 90-es évekből megmaradt Nicole szexi hangja.
Nothing happened.
Yeah.
The gem fits perfectly, but what does that prove?
Maybe the tripod has to be in a certain location.
There's nothing on the manuscript to indicate where, though, is there?
Oh, by the way, I had a visit from André Lobineau.
Oh, yeah. I hope he didn't mind me giving him your address.
Not at all. It was lovely to see him again. He was over the moon when I showed him the manuscript. It's not often he gets that excited. He made a sketch of the Nat's crest to take back to the museum. I believe he's identified the family who bear that crest.
I sure hope so.
Na, nem történt semmi, hogy ráraktuk ugye az égkövet a tripodra, de Nicole nem mondott hülyeséget, valószínűleg konkrét helyen kell lennie ahhoz, hogy bármi történjen. Úgyhogy...
I have to go.
Already?
Hát menjünk.
You only just arrived.
Time and tide wait for no man.
Okay, I'll see you later.
És ugye, ha jól emlékszem, akkor Lobineau megadta Montfaucon helyszínt, illetve hogy hol találjuk, ahol ugye nagy kivégzések voltak régen. Így van, itt van Montfaucon, úgyhogy gyerünk ide. Egy új helyszín, itt kell tovább nyomoznunk. Folytatódik a párizsi nyomozás, de csak a következő epizódban. Köszönöm szépen, hogy velem tartottatok. Itt a negyedik etapban nem sokára folytatom a Broken Sword című játékot és George kalandját. Van még bőven mit felfedezni és hova utazni, de először itt Montfaucont fogjuk egy kicsit megvizsgálni, és ezt a zsonglőrt is. A következő viszontlátásig pedig sziasztok!